From Force 13 HQ, this is April 19th, 2017. Here's your Tropical Weather Bulletin. Wednesday morning, midnight UTC, April the 19th. Invest 91L is still going in the Atlantic, dead centre in the basin as a matter of fact, and is displaying some signs of trying to become a subtropical storm, but time's running out. We've also got the remnants of 2W in the Western Pacific, was a tropical depression, still hanging on as a remnant low just to the west of the Philippines, and a little tiny blow up out of that one in the last few frames. Onto that soon. But here's Invest 91L. Wind speeds of 40 miles an hour, pressure of around 992 millibars at 30.9 degrees north, 42.8 degrees west. That's the latest information on the system. Still holding on to gale force winds from an ASCAP pass earlier today, signalling 40 mile an hour winds. We're awaiting another one in the next few hours to see how strong it is now. But the models, as you can see, the storm is predicted to move towards the north and then to be absorbed within around 24 hours by another low pressure system of extratropical nature, and that too will then move towards, sort of slaloming towards the east and then north. So here's the Atlantic Ocean wide shot right now. You can see some blasts of convection going on in the Western Caribbean of a not tropical nature. 91L, of course, off towards the top right. We'll get the close-up image of that one soon. The East Pacific, as you can see, is very quiet indeed, hardly anything at all going on there. You saw yesterday there were some thunderstorms in the southern part of the image, the far south. There's nothing there anymore, they blew themselves out. The West Pacific, you can see a big frontal system going off towards the east of Japan and another system moving into Japan, and what's left of 2W down towards the Philippines there. We'll get a close-up of that one as well in the floater section coming up shortly. And here is the Australia and South Pacific area. It's late in the season here, so it's unlikely we'll see anything more, but there still could be one or two systems that pop out momentarily, but nothing yet. Nothing suspect. In the Indian Ocean, there may be one or two things suspect there. Some thunderstorms still occurring just west of Diego Garcia. We'll be watching those, but it doesn't look like anything will result out of those in the next few days. Sea surface temperatures remain fairly warm. The Force 13's latest Nino update came out. Slight cooling overall worldwide in the last week, but still pretty warm. The Caribbean in particular looks pretty impressive right now, as does the Indian Ocean as a whole, especially the western half of the Indian Ocean. Very warm indeed, a big pool of 30 degree waters or higher, and where tropical depression, the remnants of 2W, are still very warm waters there for potential regeneration. We'll see. Here's Invest 91L. Now it looks pretty impressive, but that circulation feature there of convection appears not to be exactly over the centre of the storm. Not sure whether that's due to wind shear or something else. I would not call this a subtropical cyclone at this point. Earlier today I was looking at the wind profile, didn't really seem to match either. Time is running out for 91L, but there is still a chance that it could become a subtropical cyclone. The question is, will it have tropical storm force winds by the time it does do it, if it does? Here's the remnants of 2W and a big flare-up occurring on this tiny system in the last few frames as day has just broken there in the Western Pacific. You can compare it to the size of Luzon in the Philippines. Some storms are huge compared to the island of Luzon. This one is tiny in comparison, but could still deliver some rainfall to the area if that convective flare-up continues and spreads to the east. Whether it will become a tropical depression again, well, that remains to be seen. I doubt it somehow, but you never know what might happen in the Western Pacific. But it seems rather an oddity to see something like that just all on its own in the South China Sea there. There's the averages for 1960 to 2016. I'm sure you've seen it many times already if you're a regular viewer. And 2017, how it compares so far. We've had a storm of every category this year, but it has been a little bit on the quiet side of things, a little bit below average overall, with 15 tropical storms that have formed so far this year. Of course, 1900 there with 31, that was for the whole year. It shouldn't take too much to beat those seasons right at the bottom there. Of course, observations weren't so good back then, I guess they have an excuse. But 2017 is still a long way to go yet this year, but a lot more storms probably on the way. And these are the storm names for this year. If you've not seen them yet, you might want to familiarise yourself. I'm not going to read them out, of course, because there's so many to read through, but here they are for your convenience. You can follow Force13's outlets, the website force13.com and its tracker at your service at any time. You can also find us on YouTube, you're probably there already. Search Force13, all in text if not, and subscribe also if you haven't, it'd be very nice if you did. You can also find us on Facebook and Twitter, search Force13, all in text, at Force13 is the handle on Twitter if you'd like to get in touch. You can also add Fool13 on Skype, F-O-O-L-1-3, and add extension 9094 on Discord for tropical weather chat.